We got Young Don, the Sauce God. Let's get straight to it.
It's the dream. What's up, nieces and nephews? It's your boy, Chow.
And it's your boy, Uncle Bird. And today, we're going to be reacting to a video made by Young Don, the Sauce God. And guys, I know we've been gone for a little bit, but hey, God, we bet. And we better. So, the title of the video is called Almost Partying with Lil Yachty. So, guys, I don't know. I mean, Young Don, the Sauce God, has some good story times and some good animations, so I feel like this really should be entertaining. So, guys, let's go ahead and get to the reaction.
Let's get it.
So this story happened about a week ago. I was chilling in my room when one of my boys, Wyatt, burst into my room and is like, "Don, Ian Connor is throwing a party in Houston. We have to go." So I'm like, "All right, who's Ian Connor?" Wyatt's like, "You're joking. You don't know who Ian Connor is? Don, this is the dude who discovered Playboy Cardi, okay? We have to go." All right, for those of you who don't follow me on Twitter and Instagram, I live with two of my boys who are aspiring rappers. Super talented dude. They make up a duo that goes by the name of 340 York. The outro song for this video is actually one of my favorite songs by them. So of course, like any other aspiring artist, they're trying to blow up. And apparently this Ian Connor guy could possibly help them get one step closer to that if they got a chance to show him their music. Also, it turns out that Lil Yachty and Ugly God, two pretty popular rappers, were gonna be there as well. So anything could happen. Needless to say, we all get fresh, hop in the whip, and drive 3 hours to Houston for this party. So we roll up and oh my, it was indeed a party. The venue was a 4-story luxury apartment. We get inside and it was packed. The music is blasting, people are dancing, and realistically there must have been at least 300 to 400 people in the building. But with the way how everyone was just crammed together on the second floor where the main party was, you could have told me that there were 24,568 people there and I would have been like, yeah. Sounds about right. Now, I love parties, okay? I love mosh pits, I love the energy, and most of all, I love to dance. Your boy knows how to turn up, but only if I can get in and out whenever I feel like. You feel me? Usually at most poppin' parties, there's like a dance floor section where everyone's jumping around, having fun, going crazy to the music, right? There's that part, and then there's like a chill space where you got room to breathe. It's away from the speakers, you can actually have a conversation with someone. This is a necessary balance for any good party. That way, when you get tired of moshing and grinding on all the other sweaty, smelly people, you can exit the pit, go to the chill section, refresh, and recover. Maybe have a Capri Sun and breathe the fresh air before returning.
And if you gotta get up out of there, you can get up out of there.
This was not the case. It was just an infinite sea of sweaty bodies mushed together, jumping up and down. It smelled like armpits, Capri Suns, and organic leaf inhalers. So,
did I say a Henny Capri Sun?
Come on, bro. You know he can't say he was drinking.
As soon as I realized this, I was like, okay, we're not staying here. I grab my boys and we venture on upstairs. We get to the top floor and it is a much different energy. The people were calm, there was a lot of Capri Suns being sipped and inhalers being puffed, if you catch my drift. So the gang and I decided to kick it here for a bit and wait for the celebrities to show up. And of course, being a comedian, I instantly go into observation mode. I'm always on the lookout for some funny to talk about in my videos. And oh boy, this party did not disappoint. The first person that really caught my attention was this dude who was sitting a few feet away from me. This is exactly how it happened. I was looking down at my phone, going through my Instagram. Follow me on Instagram at ilovesauce, I'll link in bio. Then I hear some dude
Oh, you gotta put it self-promotion. Make sure y'all follow my Instagram in the description.
If you really loved me, you'd suck on my toes. I'm sorry. Did I just hear what I thought I heard? I look over at this dude and immediately I was like, okay, yeah, That makes sense. This guy looks like the kind of guy who would demand that his girl suck on his crusty ass toes. He was this fat white dude, right? Which really isn't a characteristic that should even be worth mentioning. A lot of dudes are fat, some of them happen to be white. Nothing particularly unique about that. It shouldn't be worth mentioning, but today, it is. Why? Because he was wearing a choker. You know, a choker. Those tight necklaces that girls wear around their necks so that dudes have something to grab onto when they're, hugging. That's what that's for, right? At least that's what I use it for. This dude was wearing one of those, which, as a fat dude, you can't do that, man. I'm sorry. I mean, you can do whatever you want. It's a free country. I'm just saying that it looks weird. I mean, guys in chokers, period, looks a bit off if you ask me. So, of course, I think it looks 10x worse when a dude got all his neck fat trying to burst out of the choker. But yeah, I don't need to describe this dude any further. He looks exactly what you think a grown man wearing a choker while yelling at his girlfriend about his dissatisfaction with her refusal to suck his crusty ass toes in the middle of a party would look like. Then in walks this group of kids, right? Early 20s, and I don't even know where to begin to explain this group. Like, I've never seen people like this in actual real life. Have you ever seen those videos of models on the runway? They're wearing just the most bizarre clothing. Like, the kind of clothes that make you ask yourself, who's wearing these clothes? Like, who's buying this? Where do you buy this? I've never seen this kind of clothing for sale anywhere. This entire group of people was dressed like that. I'm like, yo, is there about to be a poke?
That's that design.
Keep on battle, my G. Why does dude look like a guy I gotta beat to get my 8th gym badge? Which, yo,
Pikachu, I choose you.
Post up. Instantly, you get the whole we're trying so hard to be cool vibe from them. Like, they all pulled out cigarettes and started smoking, but they did it like they thought it was cool. On that note, do people still think that smoking is cool? Like, I'm serious, is that still a thing? I get that people smoke, and personally, I don't care. Sure, it's terrible for your health, but it's your body. Do whatever you want. But do people still smoke just because they think it makes them look cool? Because it doesn't at all. But looking at these kids, you could tell that they thought they were being cool. They had that stuck-up, I'm better than you look on their faces. Just the way they held the cigarettes, it was like, oh, look at me, I'm so cool. No, you're not. And as I'm analyzing this group of people, we suddenly hear this big commotion going on downstairs. So I'm like, finally, that must be the celebrities. Nope, it was the cops. The cops showed up. Apparently, there was some dude outside being overstimulated by Capri Suns and organic leaf inhalers. And somebody called the cops. And when 12 shows up to a party, that's never a good thing. I look over the balcony and people are just pouring out of the building like ants. And in a matter of minutes, 6 cop cars pull up to the scene and the whole street gets shut.
Sweet.
Down.
Yeah, you upstairs.
The cops are evacuating the building. The party was over. So we begin to head downstairs, and on the way, I spot a bathroom. Now, I needed to use the bathroom from the moment I got to the party, but the place was so packed, I never thought I would actually be able to get access to one. So now that people are clearing out, I was like, fuck it, I'm taking this leak. So I get to the bathroom, and I'm doing my thing, and then in the middle of relieving myself, I hear,
get out of the bathroom right now.
I'm like, okay, now I just finish using the bathroom, shake 3 times, and everything's gonna be okay. He's like,
you have 10 seconds to get out of the bathroom or you will be leaving in handcuffs.
I'm like, God, man, I can't finish taking this leak, man. Officer, just give me a second. I'll be done in a second. You hurry up and finish getting into the bathroom. Didn't even get to wash my hands, which is incredibly unsanitary. But I don't want to risk getting shot or arrested for the sake of good hygiene. So we exit the building and everyone is just standing around. A lot of people paid a lot of money to get into this party because these famous people were supposed to show up. And they never did. So yeah, people were kind of pissed. I mean, I would have been pissed too, but thankfully I'm a famous YouTuber who tells stories for a living. So this was kind of a win-win for me. And just when I thought the night was over, all the celebrities show up. They just roll up in their fancy cars. So now everyone's taking pictures, right? Swarming the van. And I'm just like, hey, look, it's a little boat. But sadly, everything went downhill from there. As far as the police was concerned, this party was over. So everyone pretty much just went home. And that's the story of how I almost got to party with famous rappers. But wait, fam, there's more.
If you do not leave now, you will leave in cuffs. Let's go.
I know. Do you want to see actual video footage from this story? Well, just so happens to be the case that I started a vlog. Basically, if you want to see firsthand what the journey to becoming one of the most famous YouTubers and rap groups in the world looks like, this vlog is for you. Watch the rise of Young Don the Sauce God and 340 Ori as we take over the game. I've already posted.
I got you, Young Don the Sauce God, all subscribe. Well, guys, I hope you enjoyed this reaction. You know, like I said before, we're back. We're here for good. But, I mean, honestly, I feel like he tells some of the best stories on YouTube. So that's why I always come back and watch him. Plus, I like to support, you know, aspiring YouTubers and stuff like that. But, hey guys, make sure you leave a like, comment, subscribe. Yes, you, I'm talking to you. Before you click off the video, make sure you hit the subscribe button. Make sure you tell your mom, your grandma, auntie, tell everybody to like, share, and subscribe. Alright guys, I'll catch y'all in the next video. Peace.